Testing communication systems. Can you hear me? You must be the new researcher HQ sent. It's nice to meet you. I'm your survey, exploration, and research assistant AI. You may call me Sarah. I'll be providing support to you during your dives. Thank you for your hard work on behalf of the Ocean Research Project. The head office reports that you're one of their best. Please begin moving so that I can confirm your location. Location confirmed. You may now swim whichever way you like. Now, let's make sure the lenses in your mask are working correctly so you can perform your research. When you scan a creature, you should be able to see its biological data. Try scanning the fish over there. Scan successful. Note that if you keep holding the button, you'll be able to scan more creatures. When you scan a new organism, its biological data is transmitted to HQ. Scan more and more organisms to build up your reputation as a researcher. You might have noticed that after you scanned it, the light you saw on it disappeared. I'll get into why that happened at a later point. This is the Veiled Sea, an ocean region whose topographical features are in constant flux. Feel free to explore, and simply let me know when you are ready to continue your dive training. We've arrived at the canyon. As you can see, there's only a narrow passage between the cliffs. Our destination is a nearby cave. I'll mark its location for you. Down currents tend to occur in areas like this, that have steep drop-offs. A down current occurs because the water is actually falling into the crevice, toward the seafloor. Isn't nature fascinating? You will notice a large reef composed of many diverse species of coral. We call this the world coral. It's home to a unique ecosystem, with numerous creatures living in and around it. Research shows it is critical to sustaining life throughout the Veiled Sea. But look here. Some parts of it are dying. The cause of this necrotizing effect isn't currently understood, but it appears to be spreading, gradually killing this bustling hub of underwater life. If the necrosis continues, a point of no return will be reached. The world coral will die. It is a critical part of the ecosystem in the Veiled Sea. So such an event would profoundly impact life here and in the surrounding ocean. Project Aegis was founded to investigate why this is happening and stop the necrosis before it's too late. You are now the newest member of Project Aegis. Welcome. Ready to get started? Of course, as your assistant AI, I'll continue to provide you with navigational guidance and research support. I should note that you will not be allowed to return to the World Coral without specific clearance from HQ. Now that you've gotten a good look at it, we'd better be on our way. Huh? My sensors are showing an increase in activity. The cave is starting to shake. Analyzing. I detect unusual biometric signs nearby. Caution advised. Sending emergency transmission to HQ. Major disruption occurring at the World Coral. Researchers in the area may be in danger. There it is, and it's enormous. It looks like an extremely large variant of coelacanth. I've searched our database, and there are few examples of a coelacanth of that size, or with that golden coloring. I understand you want to investigate, but it's not safe. Seismic activity detected. The seafloor is shifting. There's a risk that that creature will be agitated. I advise not to go near it. Use a dolphin kick to get away faster. You should be out of danger now. And your vitals readout indicates you're not hurt. It's unusual to have such a strange experience on your first expedition. Then again, this is called the Ocean of Mystery for a reason. I hope we meet that creature again. But first, you'll be learning about salvage from one of the other divers on the team. HQ reviewed our data and confirmed the creature we saw last time was a new species. I can only hope we see it again. But for today, we'll focus on finding salvage. There are lots of objects to be discovered in these waters, from household trash to ancient treasures. Part of your role as a researcher is to salvage these artifacts, bringing them to the surface so we can study them further. To help you learn, you'll be joined by another diver. Here he is now. Daniel is one of the most senior divers on the team. He's very knowledgeable about the Veiled Sea. Shall we get started? As Daniel would no doubt tell you, the best way to find salvage is to look for glowing objects on the ocean floor.
Thank you.
Salvage found. Well done spotting it. Transmission from HQ. We've been asked to relocate to the northwest and search for salvage there. Salvage found. It seems the harder something is to find, the more valuable it is. HQ has granted permission to search in the northeast. Please continue looking for salvage. This merits further investigation. I'll call Daniel over. It appears to be a stone tablet, a very old one. The square patterns suggest it might be a chessboard. I'll cross-reference against the database and try to provide further analysis. Please stand by. Result found, 74% match. This appears to be a relic of the Oans people who perished tens of thousands of years ago. Little is known about the Oans, but it's said they built a thriving civilization on the Veiled Sea. In legend, they are referred to as the Guardians of the Sea, an advanced people who lived in harmony with the ocean. The value of a genuine Oans artifact would be immeasurable. Request received from HQ. We've been asked to bring the tablet back for study. If it really is an Oans artifact, it would be a monumental discovery. HQ will confirm and provide compensation accordingly. Good morning. I hope you were able to get some rest after all the excitement yesterday. Today, I'll be teaching you about tagging. Tags are a useful way to communicate with other divers, but they can also help you navigate around in the ocean. Let's start by tagging a creature. Scan one and select the tag you want to apply while focused on it. Successfully applied. You'll be able to keep track of this creature's location on your map. tags can also be attached to salvage. Let's try it. There appears to be salvage in that area. Tag successfully applied. This salvage will now be marked on your map. You can also see tags on your map from divers who are sharing with you. I'll go into more detail about sharing later. It looks like Daniel saw your tag and decided to head this way. Receiving transmission. The researchers at HQ have concluded their study of the artifact. The artifact was confirmed to be an ancient relic of the Oans people. HQ is referring to it as the mystery board. On it are squares containing inscriptions relating to the mysteries of the Veiled Sea. They've been called the 99 Mysteries. For some reason, due to properties not understood by HQ scientists, the squares appear to be capable of producing light. Scientifically speaking, that wouldn't be possible. Then again, it would hardly be the first phenomenon we've seen with no rational explanation. The mystery board will prove very valuable if it helps us learn more about these mysterious waters, or shows us how to save the world coral. Hello there. I see someone has decided to join us for your last day of training. Daniel must be feeling competitive after you found the mystery board. Today, you'll be free to make your own way through the Veiled Sea, using what you've learned as you explore. You may notice that creatures are easier to see after you scan them, since the shroud of light around them goes away. HQ's working hypothesis is there are luminous bacteria that get repelled by electromagnetic waves from our scanning arrays. This process is known as collecting light. Thank you. Transmission from HQ. We have updated information about the status of the world coral. HQ monitoring systems have detected light emissions at the world coral and a concomitant reduction in necrotic matter. It seems that somehow, light is returning to the world coral and restoring it. Huh? Look at that. It's the same large coelacanth that we encountered last time. Risk level, moderate. While its temperament toward humans is unclear, the creature does not seem as agitated as last time. I advise trying to scan it. But please be careful. You did it. Scan successful. I'll transmit our data on the supersized coelacanth to headquarters. HQ has assigned this new species the name Raja Emma's, which translates to Golden King. It's never been studied before, so needless to say, the data you gathered will be quite illuminating. You may not know that HQ maintains a numbered database of unidentified marine life, or UMLs for short. By scanning Raja Emma's, you've officially discovered a UML. Congratulations! Your career with Project Aegis is off to a promising start. Strangely, it seems to have started shining in response to your discovery of Raja Emma's. It appears you were right. We'll have to keep an eye on the mystery board as we do our research. And with that, your training is now concluded. Between finding the mystery board and discovering Raja Emma's, it's been an eventful few days. I look forward to working with you both again. Happy diving! Thank you.
Thank you.